Hello, Dr. Vicki Peterson here, coming to you from our Root Cause Medical Clinic, where we help the world's busiest people regain, retain, and reclaim their health, their energy, and their resilience. It's February, and that's Heart Disease Month, and this is a really important topic, and one we could relegate actually to every month of the year because it's our number one killer of men and women, taking a million lives every year. Every 34 seconds, someone has a heart attack in this country. Every 60 seconds, someone dies from a heart-related disease. So it's something that should really get our attention, but I have really good news for you today, which is, despite the fact that there are about 9 risk factors that really should gain our attention, and I'll go over those, there's one that we could really put our attention on and diminish our risk almost to the degree we wouldn't even have to worry about having heart disease. So that's pretty exciting. So what are the 9 risk factors? There's overweight, stress, having diabetes. I'm not sure if you know that once you're diagnosed with type 2 diabetes, you're put in the same risk category as if you've already had a heart attack. Then there's a lack of exercise, lack of fruits and vegetables. We ask our patients to shoot for 7 to 9 servings every day. What else? A high cholesterol, of course, and abdominal obesity, so having your weight in the midsection. I think I mentioned stress. So those should have been 9 different things I just mentioned. I think I repeated a couple, but those are the factors we're really trying to limit to reduce our risk of heart disease. But what if you could just focus on one? Okay, good. So annually you should be getting a physical, at least getting a blood profile test done. Most people in the United States do that. If not, it's probably time for one. And one thing they always look at is your cholesterol, and particularly the total cholesterol, as well as your good and bad. So the bad cholesterol is known as your LDL cholesterol. That stands for low density lipoprotein. And we want that number to be between 50 and 70 to really dramatically all but erase your risk of heart disease, which is pretty exciting. Now, the average American has a number about 130, so way too high, and no wonder we are dying of heart disease in such great numbers. The lab profile usually has the high end of that number around 99 or 100. So most doctors feel if it's hovering around there, it's okay. But what research is showing us is that our average number and what we're starting to call normal is already at high risk. So we have to re-look at these numbers and recalibrate them to getting you at a number that all but erases your risk of heart disease. So what some research has mentioned is that even if you had some of the other risk factors, if that LDL cholesterol was down around 50 or 70, they said under 55 if you've already had a heart attack. If you haven't, then it could be in that 55 to 70 range. It would so dramatically limit your risk that if some other factors weren't so perfect, that would be okay. Oh, and then earlier, I don't think I mentioned smoking, so that's another risk factor. Now I think we have our 9. So then what happened was like, okay, so 50 to 70, that's true. No argument, that would really make the bad cholesterol so low, it'd be very difficult to create heart disease. But we can't do it. All right, why can't you? Because we'd have to put so many people on medication, it would be cost prohibitive. So that's the way traditional medicine thinks, but how about if it wasn't cost prohibitive at all? What if you just had to change your diet? And sure enough, a plant-based diet that has those 7 to 9 servings of fruits and vegetables and beans and legumes and nuts and seeds will get that cholesterol where it needs to be without the need for any medication. So no longer cost prohibitive. That's really our problem these days, is that there's so many good studies showing what diet does, but then everybody backs off and says, yeah, Americans won't do that. They won't change their diet. We'll let you decide if you're gonna change your diet, right? The risk Well, the rewards way outweigh the risk. And I'd love you to come visit our website where I have lots of videos on cooking. Here on YouTube, lots of videos on cooking as well as these health-related videos. Lots of recipes on the site. They're all plant-based, so they're all designed to achieve the goal that I'm talking about today. And it's early on in February, we're just a couple of days in. What if you took the next 4 to 6 weeks and said, yeah, I'm really gonna go strongly plant-based and then see what my bad cholesterol does in the blood. So if you had it tested within the year, then you know what the number is. So do this for 4 to 6 weeks and see what happens. If you need my help, that's what I'm here for. We see patients from all over the country, so you don't need to live locally to see us. Laws have changed, which allow us to telemedicine a bit. So most people do come to see us first, but depending on your health history and what's going on, we can definitely treat you long distance. So I'm excited about that. I'm really excited about this research because heart disease claims way too many lives, and there really is something we can do about it naturally. So I wanted you to have this data. Please let me know other topics you want to hear about. That's what I'm here for. And until next time, I wish you great health from our Root Cause Medical Clinic, where we help the world's busiest people. We're all so busy, but we still can regain, retain, and reclaim our health, our energy, our resilience, and really enjoy our lives. That's my wish for you.